Hi, my name is Shana. I'm a third year student in Singapore Management University. In today's video, I'll be teaching you about how I use Notion and the four main templates I find really helpful in my university life.
The most useful are my weekly agenda, my notes in class, using Active Recall, my internship tracker, as well as my book notes. So first I'll talk about my weekly agenda. Now I actually have it in monthly and then weekly, and I do have a ton of other tabs as well, but I do find the weekly agenda to be the most useful because it helps me in my delegation of tasks throughout the week. So these are actually things from my last week, and I just deleted all the to-dos. So for the next week, I'm just able to delete it and just add a new one. So these things all come pre-prepared in the template, and I got this template from Jeff Su, who's like a productivity YouTuber. So I find it a lot simpler to just use templates by other people because they've already made it really nice. And what I did when planning my Notion was just to look at a lot of YouTube videos and just downloading the free template. Whatever needs to be done this week, I first put it over here. So let's say study chapter one, then I'm able to just bring this block and drag it over here, and then if I want to add anything to Monday, I will just click on this button and it will just copy over here. And once I'm done for the entire week, I will just delete it. I also put this routine thing that was in the template, and these are the three routines that I'm trying to build over this period. So in Atomic Habits by James Clear, there is this concept of habit stacking where you try to build on one habit first. So for example, I'll try to build on stretching first, and I will continuously do it until it becomes a habit, and then I'll continue by stacking on a reading habit. So next, I will go through with you my notes in class. So these two modules that I did were the first modules I took when using Notion because I was on internship the entire year. So these were two of the modules that I did during my summer term, and I find it really helpful as like a central repository for everything related to this course. So I will just drop in the course outline whenever they update it on the website, and then I will write down the components and also customize the properties over here to things that I find useful. So the thing I find the most useful is definitely the weightage, because I'm able to see which are the components that I should focus on. And after typing in all the weightages, I just sort it according to descending, so that the highest percentage will be on the top, and then I will know that the final exam is the most important component. So whenever the prof talks about the final exam, I will just write down the details in this page over here, and that way it makes it really easy to access all the information. The more important thing would be writing down the notes. So this module had a lot of pre-reading, so I made sure to put this property first, and then after I do my readings, I will do a readings thesis, and I will go through the lecture. Then after that, I will revise the lecture by typing out the notes, and then during the weekends or during my revision week, I will type active recall notes, and then I will write the number of times I was able to successfully active recall the information. So let's say for example enlightenment, I will write an overview of what the chapter is about and the questions that I should think about, which were provided by the prof. So it gives me a bit of head start when I'm going through the pre-readings. It really helps me in my class participation because I know what he's looking out for. Then I will go through the readings and write out a thesis. And then after the lecture, I will go through the slides and just type out, but I will retype it in the form of questions. So I will do like a toggle and I will write it out here so that after I type it all out, I can just hide it and then test myself what are the consequences of colonization. And this way, I'm forcing myself to retrieve the information from my brain instead of just reading the content blindly. So how I make this is to just tap. So because it's already tapped before that, it just auto toggles. But if you're starting on a new block, you want to put slash and then toggle. And then you just type out whatever you want, and then whenever you want to put the content inside, you just put a bullet point and type everything here. Another thing I've done is to track my internships. So since I'm already in my final year, tracking my internships is super important because it helps me keep my eye on the important companies that I want to apply to. So I will keep track of the progress, the period that I'm applying for, and the latest update. So most of the HR, they don't reply you if you are rejected, and sometimes you're like waiting on it, but you're not very sure when they last replied you. So I put this last edited time. so that I would know if they haven't responded in about, let's say, a month, and then I would know that they have probably already dropped me and start panicking and looking for more internships. So this one was really helpful because some of the companies that I interviewed with, I actually tried multiple times, like Unilever and AWS. And so I just wrote down the questions that I wrote down the process of the interviews and the JDs and all the potential questions that they might ask me. And then I just keep building on it and asking people tips. So I would just keep building the page until I eventually do the interview. So the last thing I wanted to share was my book notes. So I really picked up reading actively during the circuit breaker in Singapore because we were just stuck at home. And I really wanted to read, but I felt that I was always too busy. So being at home was a really good excuse to just sit down and read with a book. And I started tracking down all the books. So if you see the dates, these are actually books that I've read in the past two to three years. I first started taking book notes because I was very influenced by Adi Abdal, who is like my most influential YouTuber. So he created this book template and I just used it. And I also read a lot of books recommended by him, but I also follow recommendations by other YouTubers like Jack Edwards. Some of the great books that I've taken notes on are The 5 Love Languages. So I'll just write the author, what genre it's in, my rating. These are all following Ali Abdal's template, so I don't really have to do anything. And I'll write the book in 3 sentences, my impression, how I discovered it, how the book changed me, my top 3 quotes. Having these summarized notes are really helpful in helping me to reflect on what I've read, but also in helping me to refer to them after. I found that this was really helpful, not just in personal life, but also at school and work, because I think I seem a little bit more well-read when I can quote books like off the top of my head or off just a simple reference from my Notion. I've tried is to do syntopical reading, which is reading a few books on the same topics and then developing your thoughts on that issue then. So I always try to pick books with very extreme opinions. And for example, like I'm quite interested in inequality, so I'm going to pick a book on Lee Kuan Yew, and this is what inequality looks like, good economics for hard times, poor economics. And this really helps me understand the different points regarding inequality and how we can resolve it from both the political, sociological, and economic perspective. It really gives me a nuanced outlook. That's all. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed my video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.